We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
Hello everyone, our subject name is Basic Electronics and our topic is Digital Circuits. Here we are going to discuss what are logic gates, type of logic gates and digital logic families. So let's start. Before learning what are logic gates, we have to learn some important term which is logic operators. So basically there are 3 logic operators. Not operator, AND operator and OR operator. Here NOT operator is denoted by bar, AND operator is denoted by dot and OR operator is denoted by positive sign. Now whenever you are using NOT operator, at that time it represents process of inversion. Now if you have A, then it is denoted by A bar. Now AND operator is used as a logical multiplication. So A dot B. Next operator is OR operator and OR operator represent logical addition. So we can simply say that A plus B or in other words A OR B. Now our main question is what are logic gates? So it is a building block for how computer works. When logic gates turn on, a certain condition is true. And when logic gate is turned off, at that time certain condition is false. Now let's remember that if there is a true condition, at that time it indicates 1. And if there is a false condition, at that time our gate indicates 0. Now let's take one example. If we have 2 alphabets, both alphabets are A and we are applying the 2 alphabets into the logic gate. Now in that logic gate we'll check if both the alphabets are equal or not. If it is the true condition, at that time our output is on, means our output is 1. Now let's take another example. Here we have 2 alphabets A and B. Now we are applying these 2 alphabets into the logic gate. Okay, so now here we are comparing both the alphabets. A is not equals to B, so they are not equal. So because of that our output is off, means 0. So that's how our logic gates work. Now before going to logic gates, we have to learn some important terms. So in that, first one is logic diagram, or it is known as logic symbol. Logic diagram is nothing but a graphical representation of a circuit. For each gate, there is a specific graphical symbol. So that symbol is known as logic diagram. Now our next term is truth table. Now what do you mean by truth table? Truth table is nothing but all the possible combinations a gate could encounter. That is known as truth table. Now next one is Boolean equation. Now what do you mean by Boolean equation? Boolean equation deal with variables that are either true value or false value. So they are perfect for describing our digital logics. Because in digital logics, there are only one output. In digital gates, there are only one output. If it is 0 means false, or it is 1, that means true. So now moving further, there are various types of logic gates available. So here 7 logic gates are listed. First one is NOT gate. Second one is AND gate. Third is OR gate. Fourth is NAND gate, fifth one is NOR gate, sixth one is XOR gate and seventh one is XNOR gate. Now here, first three gates are known as basic gates because it is derived from our logical operators. Okay. Next two gates means NAND gate and NOR gate are called as universal gates because with the help of these two gates we can make any gate. That's why NAND and NOR gate are called as universal gates. Another two is special gates which is XOR and XNOR gate. Now let's move on our first gate which is NOT gate. So NOT gate is nothing but a single input single output gate. Now here we have single input A and our single output X. Now let's see Boolean equation. We'll know that Boolean equation is nothing but a equation form of our gate. So X which is our output which is equals to A bar. A bar means complement of A. So this is the symbol of NOT gate. Now moving further, truth table. Now truth table is nothing but all the possible combinations of input. So here we have only one input. So here only two possibilities are there. If our input is 0 and if our input is 1. Now if we are applying at the input side 0 at that time from NOT gate, we are getting our output 1. And if we are applying 1 as the input at that time, we will get 0 as our output. So it is nothing but a inversion process. So NOT gate is sometimes referred as a inverter because it inverts our input value. Now our next gate is AND gate. AND gate is nothing but a two input gate. It has two inputs and one output. Now its Boolean equation is X is equals to A dot B. Dot represents multiplication. So AND gate is used for multiplication of two signals. Here two inputs are there, A and B, and our output is X. Now here because of two inputs are there, we have four possible combinations. Now how we can find possible combinations? So there is 2^2 number of inputs. That is the equation for finding possible combination. So here 2^2 possible inputs. So 2^2 because here we have two inputs. So 2^2 is 4. So here we have 4 possible combinations are there. A and B both are 0. A and B both are 1. A is equals to 0, B is equals to 1. And A is equals to 1, B is equals to 0. Now we know that AND operator is used for multiplication. So 0 into 0, 0. 0 into 1, 0. 1 into 0, 0. 1 into 1, 1. So we can say that if both the inputs are 1, at that time our output is 1. Otherwise, our output is 0. So this is the AND gate. Now our next gate is OR gate. So OR gate is made up from OR operator. So OR operator is used for addition. So our OR gate is also used for addition of two signals or more than two signals. So here we'll take one simple example. So it is two signals. So first of all, Boolean expression. So Boolean expression of OR gate is X which is equals to A or B, or in other words A plus B. Now our symbol is looking like that. In here in this OR gate we have two inputs A and B and one output which is X. Now here same four possible combinations. A and B both are our input and X is our output. Now it is addition. So So 0 plus 0, 0. 0 plus 1, 1. 1 plus 0, 1. And 1 plus 1, also 1. Why it is 1? Because whenever we are using digital symbols or digital logic, at that time in digital logic, 1 plus 1, which is equals to 1. Now moving further toward our next gate, which is NAND gate. NAND gate is nothing but a combination of NOT gate and AND gate. So here, if we remove this bubble, it is nothing but a simple AND gate. But by applying this bubble on the output terminal side, it becomes NAND gate. So our Boolean equation for NAND gate is X, which is equals to A dot B whole bar. Means this is the simple AND gate and inversion of output of AND gate. That inversion is known as NAND gate. Here two inputs are there in NAND gate and one output is there, which is X. Now here A and B, that two are our input and X is our output. Now 0 into 0, 0 into 0, 0, but here we have bubble and we have to complement. So because of that, 0 into 0 whole bar, which is equals to 1, 0 into 1 whole bar, which is equals to 1, 1 into 0 whole bar, which is equals to 1, and 1 into 1 whole bar, which is equals to 0. So we can say that NAND gate is essentially opposite of AND gate. Now moving towards our next gate, which is OR gate. OR gate is nothing but a possible combination of NOT gate and OR gate. Here A plus B, which is our OR gate, and whole bar means complement of OR gate. So here if we remove this bubble, it is OR gate. And here, if we put this bubble, it becomes NOR gate. Here, two inputs are there, A and B. And X is our output terminal. So, let's make a truth table for that. Here, A and B is our input and X is our output. Now, 0 plus 0, 0. But we have to complement it. So, it became 1. 0 plus 1, 1. But we have to complement it, so it became 0. 1 plus 0, 1, but complement is there, so it became 0. And 1 plus 1, there is 1, but we have to complement, so it became 0. So NOT gate is exactly opposite of OR gate. Now our next gate is XOR gate. XOR gate, or in other words, exclusive OR gate. Now exclusive OR gate produces 0 if its two inputs are same. Means if we have two input XOR gate at that time, if both the inputs are same at that time, this gate produces 0. Otherwise it's 1. So here see, from the truth table it is justified. If we apply A and B both input terminal as 0, we'll get our output 0. If we apply both the input terminal as 1, so at that time we'll get our output 0. Otherwise, our output is 1. So here, Boolean expression for XNOR gate is A plus circle B. Or in other words, it is known as A bar B plus AB bar. Now, this is the logical symbol. It is nothing but a OR gate with a exclusive terminal. Okay, our next gate is XNOR gate. XNOR gate is nothing but our exclusive NOR gate. Exclusive NOR gate produces 1 if our both the input terminals are same. Otherwise it is 0. So if our both the input terminals are same, at that time our output is 1. Otherwise it is 0. So here Boolean expression for XNOR gate is shown. It is nothing but the inversion of XOR gate. And here if we expand this, it is denoted by A bar B bar plus AB. So here, this is simple NOR gate, and here one exclusive terminal is there. So it is known as XNOR gate. So here, our first part of logic gates are completed. In next part, we'll see what are digital logic families, how we can classify our digital logic families. Okay. Thank you for watching.